world is becoming church.
And then, yes, that's true.
Even
if you say,
and
some
people
are saying it's nothing. What is important is the heart. That word is never true.
So what come on with you?
If
your heart is holy,
if Christ reigned there, while you are wearing that cloak, God will tell you that the cloak is
holy.
He said that that is the reason those who are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. If the Spirit of God has
you,
if God is telling you that the clothes that you are wearing is showing part, some part of your body, if Christ lives in you, you will not do so. Let us be able to dress well, because we are God's temple. God lives in you. The Bible says if anyone destroys God's church, God will destroy that person too.
No, you should not take things so easy. Christianity, and then it's a thing, we cannot grant you.
We should not take things for granted. Christianity is not easy task. Where we are walking is wide. We can go left and right. By the small and the narrow, you cannot go anyways, but rather going straight. That is how Christianity is. God that you have seen in the
world,
look at him and walk in that way. Before you believed in him before, in the beginning as you believed in him, and he was living so much in you, and your love, the first love, you know the kind of life you want. You were afraid of
him.
You were dressing very well. Why is going, you are saying, oh, it's nice. It's something. God is telling you, do not conform.
Don't follow the working fashion.
Any area says diet. Some Christians are saying that it has come to our church, so I should be part of it. I want to tell you that we live in this world, but we do not come from here. The fashion that comes, you know where it comes from.
One more, I want this fashion in the back.
Those fashions. Some people use the Spirit of God. Many are not Christians. They are worldly people. So he wants to fulfill the worldly people. That you, that God has made you his people, do not be conformed as the worldly people. When he says the word, the last of the word also is a
mouth.
Since you are the temple, do not follow a bad
life.
Fornication is
what I say.
Destroy marriage is not good. Many people live. They dance. They preach. When you go to their secret place, and they are fornicating. Many Christians fornicate and they are not afraid. Do not conform. You are God's temple. The Holy Ghost lives in you. God lives in you. He says when he destroys the church, God will destroy you too. It's my prayer that the little have seen.
I therefore humbly deliver the keys to you.
And I implore
you to dedicate it
to the worship and the service of the Lord.
To the worship and the service of the Lord.
Shall we all say amen?
Amen.
Having received this keys, on behalf of the Executive Council of the Church of Pentecost and the National Executive Council of the Church of Pentecost, Italy, I thank the Almighty God for giving you all the resources that enable you to purchase this building, did all that was expected to bring it to this appreciable position. In the name of God, the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I receive these keys and proceed further to dedicate it to the glory of God.
Amen.
Your amen is feeble.
Amen.
May I humbly call my able apostles in the pastorate to follow me as we go to dedicate this prayer.
Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.